was doing nothing but jazz. The best album that I have had the pleasure of being a part of making, the Genius of Ray Charles album, which we had done in 1958-59 on Atlantic Records, where we had the Ray Charles band playing along with the Quincy Jones arrangements of the Count Basie and Duke Ellington bands. We put an enormous group of bands together and had them all playing simultaneously in the first Genius of Ray Charles album.
Ray was the complete recording artist. Ray took gospel music and put the devil's words to it, and he started something which is just routine today.
Hey, everybody, let's have some fun. You only live for once, and when you're dead, you're done. Let the good time roll, baby.
Relationship with the people we recorded that we thought was a very personal one. And then somebody like Clyde McFadder left. Bobby Darin left. At one point, Ray Charles left. We were really stunned and hurt personally. I don't think it hurt us in a financial way so much, because at that time we were beginning to grow and we had a lot of other resources. But on a psychological and a social level, it was very hurtful. And I'm still sore at Ray Charles for having left us. I really am, because I thought it was very, very unfair, and I thought he could have stayed with us, and we could have done for him what anybody else could do for him. But, I mean, that's all water under the bridge, as they say.
You know it. Girl, I know.
Coming up, Wilson Pickett plus Ben.
Yeah, I've been a virgin. I'm a virgin.
During their long history was matched by the number of fine lead singers who drifted in and out of the lineup. They made the Drifters kings of uptown rhythm and blues. One Drifter who went on to have a successful solo career under Ahmet's guidance was Benny King.